Alright, so my previous video was a quick unboxing of the Huawei Pura 70 Ultra. Today, let's set it up. I want to show you the setup step by step. I also want to show you how easy it is to install Google Apps on this. And then once that's done, I'd love for you to ask me any questions you have so that I can check those out for you and tell you in a few days how it's been using Google Apps. So let's jump right in. Alright, so here we have the Huawei Pura 70 Ultra. I have their stock case on it, a nice little slim case, but that's the phone, nice beautiful leather back, but that's not what we're here for right now. Let me just put this back on, and here we have it. So let's begin the setup. So first we've obviously got language selection, region. I'm going to select United Arab Emirates. I'm going to agree and continue. Wi-Fi, I had already previously connected it, and here, so fingerprint ID is a step that you would get onto. I've already set that up, so I didn't want to waste time on that. Face recognition is really pointless with when they don't have any other protections apart from a camera. And then we've got the Huawei ID. Alright, so once that's done, you enable cloud if you want to. I'm going to enable it later in settings. Then you've obviously got Huawei in-app purchases, which we can also add later. Then we've got the HMS core. Now over here, one thing I like is that there literally is all the stuff that you might get asked for, an ad or anything on those lines. That pops up right here. Like even Google doesn't do this that much. So I gotta give it a little respect. But basically I've disabled all these ads, the smart ads, ad statistics, everything. In terms of enhanced services, you can set them up manually if you want. Wi-Fi Plus, weather service, AI search, AI life, AI voice, AI touch, AI lens, all these are there. This is your choice if you want to set them up. I'm going to say no thanks for later. In terms of same thing with analytics, location of course is fine. Enable software update. Now at this point, I will update setup as a new device. And then we have these apps that you can add from the app gallery. I'm going to deselect all, click next, and here we have the phone. This phone, since it's the global version, has EMUI 14, so that's this. Now, as far as Google is concerned, you have to install two very simple apps, Gbox and MicroG. Gbox is what allows you to download all the other apps, and MicroG is what enables the Google Play Store, which once installed, you can use the Play Store absolutely normally. Let's look into that. So here, I'm going to first and foremost just show you a few of this extreme clutter of apps that they already have. Now for us in here in the UAE, they have some local apps already set up. They just want to show us how many apps are already on the app gallery. That's kind of the idea here. Then you've got a whole bunch of games. Now these aren't downloaded. They're all ready to download with the links. So all that is there and here. But here we're here for the Google. So let's jump right into that. Now for Google here, we can just do a quick later. Ignore, agree, and allow one use. And here I will search for MicroG. So here, I think it's actually on the app gallery already. Let me just check that. Yeah, MicroG service. So you install this and you've got the companion that comes along automatically because it's a companion. Sorry, couldn't resist. And once you have that, you just open it. You do a checkup of if all the services are here. For all these, you can activate them based on requirement. Go to Google Accounts. You add a Google account. Now at this point, obviously, this is where your decision is involved because obviously a third party is gaining access to your Google account. For the purposes of this video, I'll show it to you. So at this point, I'll sign into my account. And here we have it. I've signed into the account. Google will take a minute to activate. Now I've added this account over here, right? So you've got your authentication settings and stuff like that. And now we will go into getting ourselves the next app, which is Gbox. And here, if you notice, there's also Google Play, which I can get. And Google Play should log in. And there we have it. So Google Play and a bunch of apps, which I'll show you in just a minute. So just to recap, we installed an app called MicroG and another app called Gbox, which allows the installation of Google services. So now let's see what Gbox does. So here I have Gbox, I'm just going to open it. And as you will see, it has all Google apps that aren't otherwise available. So I'll click on this, I can install. Now, like I said earlier, the great thing about this is that I can directly go into the Play Store and install these as well. I'm just going to use Gbox because, well, everything's already sort of set up here for me. So I'm going to allow app installs. Right, it does that whole security check thing. And one by one, you can install all these apps. Now, as you'll notice, installation is a bit of a two-step process because you're going through Gbox. But just so you guys see what I'm talking about, let me show you how this works. Just one second. So from, I forgot how to do this. From here, we hold down and create shortcut, and we've got a shortcut for the Play Store. Now I open the Play Store. Now let me just use it as normal for, let's say, I'll just type Google and see what apps we can get. And we've already got these installed. So let's get Google Maps. Let's get Google Drive is already done. Let's get Google Chat. As I said, there's always a double security check, so keep that in mind. So basically that second verification that's happening at the point of installation is nothing more than the app going through Gbox, because obviously it can't go through the Play Store and get installed. So that's kind of what's happening. I hope you guys have understood that till now. Now I'm just going to zoom through as I install a few more apps over here. Just a few more that I want. So one small thing that I did notice right now is that Google Calendar doesn't work. Let me show you. So I went down to the Play Store, went to Google Calendar, clicked install, and it goes through, the whole process happens, and then this shows up. Please download it from the device's official app store or wait for a future application update. Gbox cannot install this at this moment. So that's a really funny little thing. Let me see if it installs over here. So I guess what this is doing is it's looking for it from an APK website and installing it. So that might just work, but let's just check it out. It should be done in a second. And it does. Okay, allow it, install. And okay, seems like it should be working. Yep, we have it. So I guess one thing to learn is that there's always a way around it. All right, so there we have it. A bunch of Google apps installed on a Huawei phone, all thanks to Gbox and MicroG. Let me just show you very quickly a few apps that are working. So obviously, first and foremost, we've got the Play Store working over here on a logged in account. Then we've got Instagram, which opens up, but I haven't logged in yet. Drive, all my files already here. Meet, working. Gmail, I guess I have to get into it. Take me to Gmail. And we have Gmail here as well. Ah, Maps. Let's see, and now if you notice by those permissions, all these permissions are going through MicroG. So every single Google surface is going through it. So I guess the part you have to remember is that all your access is going through a third-party app. That is that crucial decision that you need to make if you're going to use a Huawei device. Or let me say it this way, if you're going to use a Huawei device with Google services. So maps doesn't seem to be working, but could that be because I'm indoors? No, but that shouldn't make a difference. Let's try again. Oh, there we go. So now it's telling me to do a little permission set. So that's basically, I'm guessing, for all the time for, yep. And there we go. Google Maps working out pretty easy. All right, so just before I wrap up, one last thing that I want to talk about, and this is focused to people in the UAE because obviously I'm based here in the UAE, but I also do want to show what all apps are already on the app gallery, right? So first and foremost, let's look into, we've got some banking apps. Now these are really important. So you've got UAE Pass, Mashriq UAE. Let me just see if I can get that a bit clearer for you guys. Yeah, so we've got UAE Pass, Mashriq UAE, UAE Pass being very, very crucial. So that's there. Then in terms of these, we've got Noon and Talabat, all daily useful apps, Dubizzle. These are at least apps that I use on the regular. On a social front, we've obviously got TikTok, we've got CapCut, we've got all those as well. So the reason I'm showing this is that the app gallery is constantly growing, and there is no denying that there are a lot of apps that you really don't have any issues with. It's all the US-based apps that are problematic. And to be honest, a lot of the services can be used through other apps as well. You don't necessarily need the actual Google app to run certain services. If you are a Huawei fan, or if you are just sick of everything out there and you want to use Huawei but you want your Google, this is a possible solution for you. I personally, I'm going to be using this phone for a few days for the first time, like in the sense I'm going to be using a Huawei phone post the ban with all these Google services on it for the first time. So I'm going to be checking that out. Let me know what you guys have in mind. Is there anything specific you want to see? I'm going to use the phone out and about and try to sort of gauge how the services are. I will be obviously doing a review of the phone itself because I'm super excited to check out the Pura 70 camera as well. So yeah, most importantly, don't forget to like and subscribe. Thank you very much for watching, and I will see you at the next one.